Hello and welcome to CGTN. We're at Jiyuan in central China's Henan province. Actually, this place is a hometown for a very famous Chinese fable character called Yugong, also known as the man who tried to move the two mountains in front of his doorsteps rock by rock. Imagine all this work back in ancient times. That's almost a mission impossible. But without further ado, let me first introduce my guest today, Miss Wu, a local resident here in the city. She is going to join us on this tour and show us what the spirit is about, the Yugong spirit. Okay, 吴女士, 我们可以, 开始我们的这个旅程,
好嘞,
好嘞, so first, please introduce to us what is the story about, actually, what is 愚公移山? 这个愚公移山的故事大概是怎么样的典故?
愚公移山这个故事呢,可能在中国可以说是家喻户晓。 但是对于我们的这个外国朋友可能有点陌生。那么今天呢，来到我们这个河南济源呢，它就是愚公移山故事的发祥地。那么这是一个什么样的故事呢？就是在这里啊，有两座大山，太行王屋二山，方700里高万仞。 那么在这里呢，居住着一位老人，90岁的老人，他就是愚公。那么这两座大山呢，挡住了他们家的这个出路，就在他们家门口，他就想着要把这两座大山怎么能够把它移开，然后他们可以走出去。然后呢，so
sorry for interrupting, Miss Wu. Okay, for our audience, so this place is called Wangwushan. It's called Wangwu Mountain. It's actually one of the two mountains our main character tried to move. Actually, there's two mountains. Oh, there are two mountains. One of them is called Wangwu. The other is called Taihang, right? So right in front of the doorsteps. So in front of his door. So he's like, oh God, every single day I open the door and there's two mountains in front of me. So why don't I just remove the two mountains? Well, rock by rock. So this is unimaginable, right? This is 过去的时候他是靠徒手。是的，就是靠担子担呀。
还靠徒手呀，靠这个镢头呀，这样来这开挖这个大山。Oh,
actually, we can see the statue right here, right? Is that the
肩扛呀，人挑呀，还有那边看两个人。See,
that's how they do it back then. Wow, a lot of labor right there, a lot of work. So all they think was like moving the two mountains in front of them. So it was like two obstacles in front of them.
是，那个他就是一种欲言又止这个困难，哎，他就是怎么来克服困难，不畏艰险。那么愚公呢，那他就这个和全家人在一起商量怎么办。那么这中间呢，就出现了一位智叟，智叟就来说，凭你的力气怎么能搬走两座大山，简直是一个笑话。但是老愚公呢就说了，我即使说我搬不走，但是有我的儿子，儿子呢还有孙子，孙子呢再有儿子，子子孙孙无穷匮也，怎么可以搬不走呢
？Okay, so his neighbor called the wise man, and he mocked the man, said, "Okay, this is impossible. You can't just remove the two mountains overnight. Well, it will take forever." And the man said, "Okay, if I can't finish this job, my sons and my grandchildren will do this continuously." So after times after time, this work will eventually be done. Now the mountain won't grow any taller, but we have all the time in the world.
但最后呢，是他的这种精神的感动了天地，然后他们就面跨鹅，跨鹅是这个来把这两座太行王屋二山搬走了，他们就哎道路畅通，看到我们今天你看王屋太行山上这个可以说是道路通畅。刚才呢，你们也过来，这个条条大路是那个可以说济源现在这个道路呢，在全省都是非常有名的。So
according to the fable. The god sent two of his men. Well, this giant arm, the bicep, is one of the god's bicep, actually. So they sent two gods to carry the mountains away and remove them. And because they were touched by the spirit, the determines and persistence of the Yugong spirit. That's exactly what we need right here, right? 所以这个精神的话，其实是一种这个寓意里面的一种，就是传承下来很久的一种中华民族的一种精神，对不对？对，这个精神呢，可以说。
是济源的精神，也是我们河南的精神，更是全中国的这种精神。Okay,
so Miss Wu told us this is the spirit for Jiyuan, the origin of the Yugong story, and also for Henan, and also on a larger scale for China.
那么我们这个在济源呢，哈，刚才我们讲的这个愚公移山，它只是一个神话传说。 但是这种精神呢，在济源呢，还有一个现实版的愚公移山的这样一个故事。
Okay, so
不知道您听过没有
？I've never heard of that. So basically, Miss Xu says, this is actually a real story. Actually, it's not only a fable. In the 80s, right? And back in 1985, there's a man who tried to do the same thing as Yugong.
对，那么这个故事呢，就是十年修一路的故事，也是我们的这个愚公移山的这个现实版的这样一个故事。Mm-hmm. 它就发生在我们这个河南济源的一个水洪石村。
So in a tiny village in Jiyuan, and a man built the road in 10 years with bare hands.
那么水洪石村呢，它是位于河南和山西交界的这样一个太行山上，是济源市海拔最高、地理位置最偏僻的一个行政村。那么他们之前呢，就是80年代这个之前呢，他这个可以说是，如果说想出山，就仅有一条盘旋在这个悬崖峭壁上的一条羊肠小道，非常非常的艰险。
According to our audience, they said they're not really familiar with this story. They checked in Wikipedia, which is encyclopedia on the web, and they don't seem to have this thing on the internet. So we might need some more explanation on this. 那个徐女士，她可能网友在网上，就是国外网友在网上可能没有查到这个典故，我们不知道是因为是一个 fable， 还是因为这是一个虚构的故事呢，还是因为什么其他原因？
这个是真实的这样。
这是一个真实的故事。So Miss Xu told us this is real. This is real, for real. So apparently that's some reenactment of the situation back then in the ancient times, and that man I believe is the Yugong, actually, and they're having a meeting right here.
这是愚公和全家人在一起，可能在这个商量。
哦，
我们怎么来这个挖山
？Okay, so this is a family meeting. They're planning to
动员全家人。
Okay, so they're planning to move the mountains. Okay, having a meeting right here. Okay, let's move along. And that one, it's got to be the wise man.
这个愚公这个。Oh,
okay. That's the wise man who, the Yugong's neighbor, right? Neighbor who has been telling him, "Oh, you can't do this." But guess what? It's finally, you know, it's done. Okay, let's continue our trip here. And wow, look at this house. This so we have the. Real version of the Yugong in the 1985, and now, but now people don't have to dig the roads by themselves, right? 现在人们应该不需要是纯手工去挖这个路什么的，这种情况应该不会再。
现在是全部肯定都是这种机械化的呀。
Okay. So it's when in the modern times now, people don't have to dig the road anymore. They have like machines, heavy machineries to do the heavy loads works.So don't worry about it. So, 我们现在这个政府在这块有什么样的，就是比如在基建这块做出了什么样的一种贡献呢？
在这。
Oh, wow. We're in front of a beautiful art piece right here. I believe this is done by Mr. Xu Beihong. The background of the story.Actually, this is about Yugong removing the mountains, but the background of the story, the background of the painting, not the art piece, is during the, I think during the war against Japanese aggressions in China, I think about 1940s, I believe, if I'm correct. So let's continue our trip right here, and quite a scenery. So that two mountains, the mountains over there are, 这个是哪座山呢？
这个应该是王屋山。
这是王屋山。So actually, we're on the one of the mountains the, Yugong trying to move, called 王屋。王屋山它还有什么其他的一些这种比较有名的一些？
你看，你看这个地方哈，我。 这个地方你看我们这儿有这样的一个标语哈，下定决心不怕牺牲，排除万难去争取胜利。实际它这个也是最初的这个
Who said this?
愚公移山精神，
愚公啊，也是愚公 spirit。
对，当初呢，就是1945年的6月11号，这个毛泽东在这个
Chairman Mao said this。整个一个背景是什么样的背景呢？
嗯，他这个是应该是1945年6月11号，这个毛泽东主席在这个七大闭幕式上，这个发表了这个讲话，就是号召全党要下定决心，不怕牺牲，排除万难去争取胜利。那么。从这之后呢，这个愚公移山精神呢，愚公移山呢，它就从一则这个寓言故事、神话的故事，变成了一种民族的精神。它不光是在济源，而且在全国，可以说是在这个革命呀、建设和改革开放时期都发挥出了巨大的精神。
So in 1945, Chairman first brought this up, and now the fable has become a spirit.And no matter how difficult the situation is, we will get the job done. No matter how hard it is, no matter how much time it will take. Well, that's the spirit. 就是毛主席说的这句话，是不是？
下定决心，不怕牺牲。
No matter how hard it is,
well, 去争取胜利。
Wow, it's really philosophical from a fable to a spirit. And 这个愚公精神出，我觉得不光是中国的一种精神，其实也是世界的一种精神。您同意吗？这个？
对。现在呢，这个很多这个外国朋友也到这个地方哈，学习这种愚公移山精神。
Okay, a lot of foreigners come here to study this, the fable story and the spirit of 愚公。
它实际是一种这种不畏艰险，攻坚克难的这种精神。
So you gotta have the spirit to finish the hard tasks. Okay, speaking of the hard tasks, I believe we're reaching something for the end of the tour, but we gotta try this. 听说上面是有一个是体验式的那种。
体验当年这个挖山搬山的这种。
So, we are going to try this in real time, you know, to find out what's it like to remove the mountains rock by rock, but using bare hands only, Well, coach, if you're watching this, I think I'm going to do enough workout today and let's skip leg day tomorrow. Oh, President Xi Jinping said that. Okay, no matter how tall the mountain is, we will finally reach the top, and no matter how long the road is, we will finally reach the destination. Oh, philosophical right here. All right.And more stairs. Wow, look at that. It's two mini-sized mountains right there called Mount Taihang and Mount Wangwu. So it's two tiny little mountains. Let's try if we can move them. I feel what they have done in the past. Rocks. Wow, look at that. A lot of rocks, man. And I have to carry that all the way to there? 是吗？我要把这一整个全搬上去。Wow.
你可以当
设计师。
当年，愚公带领子孙。
That's okay. It's okay. I can handle that. I'm a big man. I can do that. Woo! All right, let's do this. 1, 2, 3. All right, coach. Oh wow, that's really heavy. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh, I'm okay.Well, I guess this is the end of my tour today, but I'm really feeling the heaviness on my shoulders, and that is the Yugong spirit. Oh, whoa, whoa, snap. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to try it out and feel the Yugong spirit, be with us.I suggest you visit this place in Wangwu Mountain in Jiyuan in central China's Henan province. Coach, I love you, Coach. All right, let's you know, call it for a day. Oh wow, this is really heavy. Oh, Yugong, way to go. Now that's the spirit we're talking about. Stay tuned for more. All right, thanks for watching. Bye for now.